Hey guys, so yesterday I put out a quick vlog on Python salaries, and according to YouTube, that was unsuitable for advertising, so they blocked the ads on it. Strangely enough, I asked for a review, so we'll see what they do. It was an interesting vlog, at least from my perspective, and I think from a lot of other people's perspective. So I decided to do a similar thing with web development. So let's take a look at that. All right, I'm here at the little shameless plug, shop.killer video store. If you want to learn web development, this is the best course package ever put together. So you can check that out. So right up here, bring this to your attention. Web developers average yearly salary in the USA is $77,855. So we click through, and that takes us to Indeed.com. Web developer salaries, United States, from 56,640 employees. Here we go, $77,854. This is the average. Of course, it goes up to 166, and you can look around popular companies what they're paying in terms of their web developer salaries. So your particular area where you live in the world will obviously affect this, but at least it gives you an idea of where web developer salaries sit in terms of the larger scope of things here. Salaries related to entry-level web developer, here it is, 60,000. That's not bad. This is all US dollars. So that's a pretty good senior, 100,000. Not as good as Python. If we go to Kill Sites, Video Store, Video Courses, Python 3, my Python course. Where is it? Where is it? All right here. Yeah, so a Python salary in the United States, average, significantly higher, I suppose. Different skill set. Now, before you web developers get sad and unhappy that you're not making as much as Python, this is for people who are getting jobs, salaried employees, and let's look at the juniors. Juniors, 73,000. Juniors, discrepancy is not that big with juniors versus entry-level web developer. Now, here's the thing. There's a lot of factors that go into this that separate out web developers versus Python programmers. For instance, depends on the Python programming that you do. What's driving up this Python programming, a lot of this is the AI and machine learning, that is for sure. And in terms of web development jobs, it really depends on the type of web development work that you're doing. Well, whether you're doing PHP based or C Sharp based or Java based or Ruby based, that will definitely affect your salaries. What I would suggest that you do, if you're inclined to freelancing, if you like working on your own, you feel that you can be a self-starter that way, and I talk about that in my courses, then I would suggest as a web developer, you go in there as a freelancer. And the reason being is that if, for instance, if you look at the average salary, they can pay you 77,854. For the sake of argument, we'll say 80 grand. They have to double up on what they pay you, what they charge their clients for the time. So if they can pay you 80 grand, they're charging their clients 160 grand. Keep that in mind. If you learn to become a freelance web designer or web developer rather, you could get in there and start charging, making that big money, that 160 over time once you establish yourself. And I've talked about this in other videos where as a freelancer, you develop workflows. You concentrate on a particular type of work, particular framework, maybe. Maybe you'd be a Laravel specialist. And so when you go into a job, you'll be able to leverage Laravel and to produce work at a very, 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 very efficiently. Now, at first, when you're a beginner, you're going to be fumbling around a little bit and your workflows won't be nearly as refined. But after a little while, if you do it properly, your workflows will become very refined. Instead of taking 10 hours to do something, you'll do it in two. Meanwhile, you charge your client seven or eight. And that's where you can take going from making 77,000 US to double that or more. And I know some people who are developers who got so good and their workflows were so good that they were making the equivalent of $500,000 a year. But that's because they just, this is after a few years of developing good contacts, good connections, having good workflows, having invested in certain technology to speed up their development process. I'll give you another example. There's a huge demand for WordPress developers. That's kind of like a WordPress specialist or WordPress developer is kind of a specialized web developer where you just work with customizing WordPress and maintaining WordPress, adding features to WordPress, whether it be theme creation or modification, whether you're building specialized plugins, or whether you're just setting it up so that it's secure and WordPress is set up in such a way that it works for a particular business. You got to remember, so many small businesses out there that rely on WordPress, and there's a big, big market for that. And it's kind of a niche because a lot of the new developers, they don't want to touch WordPress because they just don't like it. And so they're getting into other things. Meanwhile, on the flip side, you got tons of companies that are on WordPress and they're desperately looking for WordPress people. I have a friend of mine who has a company and he's been looking for WordPress, somebody to do WordPress for him for over a year now. And they're still having trouble, more than that. And they're willing to spend like $20,000, $30,000, $40,000, $50,000 to get their WordPress site fixed up because they need it. It's core to their business and they can't find anybody. So that's kind of a niche. That's not kind of. It's a niche that you can get into and do very well by. Nonetheless, you look at in terms of jobs, you can see clearly that the Python people can make more money than the web developers, all things being equal. But as I always say in my courses, what you have to do is you have to look at the type of work that you want to do before you jump into a particular area. That said, if, for instance, you decide you're going to go for this, and well, this being the bigger money that attracts you, and you get into Python, and then you see that the high-paying Python jobs may be AI-related, and you don't want to do AI work because it's just not your cup of tea, did you waste your time learning Python? Heck no. No chance of that, because especially if you do my Python courses, what you see is that the foundation, the core of programming, whether it be Python, whether it be JavaScript, Java, PHP, whatever, is very similar. So all that you learned in Python will be, a lot of it anyway, will be applicable for web development and vice versa, by the way. Anyway, I hope that is handy to you. I think that looking at average salaries is something useful.